about the parathyroid hormone activity. Parathyroid hormone activity, it will stimulate the release of the parathyroid hormone in case of what? It decreases ionized calcium, increasing the phosphate, decreases the active form, decreases the vitamin D, decreases the vitamin D 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D. So we have three cases here. We have decrease in ionized calcium, increasing the phosphate, and decrease in 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D. This will stimulate the parathyroid gland to release the parathyroid hormone. Then the parathyroid hormone will go for the activity of the vitamin D and will go to the renal tubular cells. In the renal tubular cells, leading to activation and synthesis of 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D. And also there is another function, which is increase calcium reabsorption and decrease phosphate. Increase calcium reabsorption and decrease phosphate. So in the urine will be the opposite. In the urine will be the opposite. So increase in the calcium reabsorption. So in the urine there is decrease in the calcium, and if there is decrease in the phosphates, the urine will increase the phosphate. So the net result is what? Increase in the calcium and decrease in the phosphate in the serum. Increase in the calcium and decrease in the phosphate. This will lead to negative feedback on the parathyroid hormone to decrease the parathyroid hormone release from the parathyroid gland. Then in the renal tubular cells, there is activity of 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D, which will go as a negative feedback on the parathyroid gland to decrease the parathyroid hormone. Then the parathyroid hormone will go for the activity of the vitamin D, will convert that 25 dihydroxyl vitamin D into 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D. So 25 hydroxyl vitamin D into 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D through 1 alpha hydroxylase. So the activity of the parathyroid hormone is achieved by increase in the activity of 1 alpha hydroxylase. So decrease in the phosphate or increase in the parathyroid hormone will stimulate the 1 alpha hydroxylase to convert 25 hydroxyl vitamin D into 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D, which is the active form, which will go to the intestine and bone. In the intestine, leading to reabsorption of the calcium and phosphate, and in the bone, leading to bone resorption and increase in the calcium and phosphate. So the net result is increasing in the calcium and phosphate. So in the vitamin D activity, the net result increase in the calcium and phosphate. But in the renal function, there is increase in the calcium and decrease in the phosphate. Increase in the calcium, decrease in phosphate. But in the intestine and bone, increase in the calcium and increase in the phosphate. Then the regulation by decrease in the serum calcium, there is increased release of the parathyroid hormone, increase in the phosphate, leading to stimulation of increased parathyroid hormone. So we have here a decrease ionized calcium or increase the phosphate, or decrease in the vitamin D. There will be stimulation for the parathyroid gland to release the parathyroid hormone. So decrease in the serum calcium, increase in the serum phosphate, leading to stimulation of release of the parathyroid hormone. Then regarding the magnesium, there is mild degrees or severe degrees in the magnesium. Mild degrees leading to stimulation of the parathyroid hormone, stimulation of the parathyroid hormone secretion. But if there is severe degrees in the serum magnesium, leading to degrees in the parathyroid hormone secretion. The common causes for degrees in the magnesium, it's called DADA. What is DADA? DADA, diarrhea, aminoglycoside, diuretics, alcohol. So DADA is diarrhea, aminoglycoside, diuretics, and alcohol. This is decrease in the magnesium. Then the parathyroid hormone, it's released from the sheaf cells of the parathyroid gland. So the function of it increase the free calcium in the blood, reabsorption of the calcium. This is the primary function, increase in the calcium. And increase in the calcium and phosphate through reabsorption of in GI system. This pathway, increase in vitamin D activity through a parathyroid hormone will stimulate 1 alpha hydroxylase to become more active form of the vitamin D, which will go to the intestine, leading to reabsorption of the calcium and phosphate, and also into the bone, leading to reabsorption and resorption of the bone, leading to increase the calcium and phosphate. So here there is increase also in the calcium and phosphate because there is bone resorption. There is also increase in the calcium reabsorption and decrease in the phosphate reabsorption through the there is distal convoluted tubule and there is proximal convoluted tubule. Regarding increase in the calcium reabsorption and decrease in the phosphate, he speaks about this pathway, which will end by increase in the calcium and decrease in the phosphate through the action of parathyroid hormone on the renal tubular cells, which will stimulate reabsorption of the calcium and decrease in the phosphate. Then the active form of the vitamin D 125 dihydroxyl vitamin D production through 1-alpha-hydroxylase. 1-alpha-hydroxylase in the proximal convoluted tubule. So 1-alpha-hydroxylase activity is achieved by parathyroid hormone. Parathyroid hormone will go and stimulate 1-alpha-125 dihydroxyl vitamin D will stimulate formation of it through what? Through it will increase the action of 1-alpha-hydroxylase to convert the inactive form to active form. Then we have the parathyroid hormone. Parathyroid hormone will increase the serum calcium, decrease in the phosphate, and increase in the urine phosphate. Why? Because there is decreased reabsorption of the phosphate. So, of course, the phosphate will increase in the urine. This is the most important one. Increase in the urine CMB. Increase in the urine CMB and increase in the parathyroid hormone. So, we have here two types of cells. We have osteocytes and we have osteoblasts. But the most important one, osteoblast, and we speak about osteoclast. So osteoblast and osteoclast. Osteoblast will release rank L receptor activator of nuclear factor kappa B ligand. So rank L will be secreted from the osteoblast to bind to the rank receptor, on the osteoclast, leading to more activation of the osteoclast for bone resorption, This is in cases of what? Increased parathyroid hormone. But if there is intermittent release of the parathyroid hormone leading to stimulation of bone formation. So the release will differ here. If it's intermittent or increase more and more in parathyroid hormone, increase more and more, so leading to activity of the osteoclast, bone resorption. But in the parathyroid hormone intermittent release, there is bone formation. There is something so important here, which is the parathyroid hormone related peptide. It's released in cases of malignancies. So we have squamous cell carcinoma of the lung and renal cell carcinoma. Leading to release of parathyroid hormone related peptide, which will act like parathyroid hormone and will do the same function in cases of malignancies.